king of fish, the Atlantic salmon, has long been a resident in the Mulkear catchment. However, over the last 140 years, the Mulkear River has been subjected to extensive drainage works, which has led to the straightening of the river and the degradation of the river channel and its riparian habitats. Past drainage practices have reduced the productivity of the river, which has led to a decline in the number of Atlantic salmon present in the Mulkear. This is something MulkearLIFE has worked tirelessly to reverse through innovative in-stream restoration works.
The salmon's life cycle is quite complex. Essentially, they spawn in those gravel shoal areas, in the headwater areas. The young fish, when they hatch out, have to spend on average 2 years in fresh water. So they live in the Mulkear, gradually moving down the system. Eventually, as two-year-old fish, they become what we call smolts. They silver up and they go to sea, and then they can spend anything from 15 months to 3 years at sea before they return to the natal river, the river they were born in, to reproduce themselves. The drainage here in the Mulkear had a negative impact on salmon production. Many of the rivers in Ireland, going back right back to famine days, were drained, which meant they were lower, they were widened, they were straightened. In scientific terms, essentially, that destroyed their morphology. It simplified them. It removed a lot of the physical complexity. And once you do that, it has negative impacts on the ecology of the river.
The Mulkear, in terms of its relative size, is considered one of the top five salmon rivers in Ireland. So it's a hugely important river. And what we've been trying to achieve through our in-stream measures is we've been trying to increase the stock. We've been trying to improve habitat, increase the complexity of the drain sections of the Mulkear catchment.
And once you do that, the natural ecology recovers itself. And our experience has been that we don't need to stock fish anymore. If we get the physical form right, the natural ecology will recover and the fish numbers will increase.
Mulkear and District Anglers Association are an association of anglers that are mainly fishing for salmon and trout. What anglers are looking for are a plentiful supply of fish and to be able to get into the river to catch them. And there we want to ensure that the spawning grounds are right, the food is right, and then we'll get our salmon back and we can enjoy fly fishing and all the types of fishing along the line.
The thing about the fishing in the river was it was actually going downhill before the catchment management program was put in place. It has done a lot to stabilize the fish numbers, and there has been very good work, in-water work done.
The OPW has been involved in this project since the beginning of the project for the last 5 years. We carry out a lot of river work, so we have an expertise in that. Placing random boulders is basically what it says. It's putting the rocks in the river to create diversity in the river. So whereas the river before, it could have been fairly uniform, when you have random boulders in it, it sets up a local current, it sets up a local area for protection for fish, for hiding, for feeding. And figures from the fisheries have proved that the random boulders have increased fish numbers and have been a success. So the OPW, we're delighted with that.
Rubble mats are the placement of rocks 200 to 400 millimetres in size onto a riverbed during the summer months between July and early August, when water levels are at their lowest. They increase the river flows over the mats when river levels are slow, and it increases plant growth, which salmon and lamprey can feed off.
We also have put in vortex weirs and rock deflectors. These enhance the river. They improve the habitat for salmon. Basically, this involves, again, importing rock into the river and constructing structures under the guidance of the EU-LIFE fisheries project team.
Weirs too have another negative effect on channels. Because it's like building a wall across the channel, they pond the water back and turn it into a canal upstream, sometimes for very considerable distances of several kilometres. And that kills the wildlife living in that channel. Because if the river's not moving and twisting and turning, an awful lot of animals, including the salmon and trout, won't live there anymore. So by taking the weir out, or even breaching it, as we did in this case, we've dropped the water level upstream for almost a kilometre here and hugely increased the productivity of all animals living in that section.
This is Ballycloch Weir, this beautiful, beautiful site on this majestic Mulkear River. It's a very old stone weir. It dates back more than 150 years, and it was a major barrier up until the summer of 2013 to sea lamprey passage. So what we did last year, last summer, we partially removed a significant section of the weir and then did reinforcement works on both sides of the river. This work was undertaken for a range of reasons, obviously the most important being sea lamprey passage, but also there was significant illegal fishing activity taking place at this point for salmon, and salmon were being held up here and were being taken out. So what we have now done through this work, we have facilitated not only sea lamprey passage but also greater conveyance of salmon throughout the system.
MulkearLIFE has also undertaken electrofishing survey work at various sites in the Mulkear catchment. Electrofishing is a common and safe method of surveying fish populations to assess fish stocks. It involves the use of specifically designed equipment which passes an electric current through the water. This stuns the fish temporarily. They're then collected with a net, fully recorded, and then immediately released back into the river.
All of the monitoring data we've collected indicates quite clearly that this type of program is very successful. And it has now entirely replaced hatcheries as a means of enhancing stocks. And of course, if you improve the environment, you're improving the wild stock. The hatchery fish is no substitute.
The Mulkear River is one of the top five salmon rivers in Ireland and produces a significant annual salmon run. The salmon population has been affected by drainage works and faces many obstacles during this upstream migration. A key aim of MulkearLIFE is to counteract drainage work by mimicking conditions found in natural or undrained rivers through specific in-stream work. Structures such as rubble mats, random boulders, and stone vortex weirs have all helped to enhance in-stream complexity of the river. Ballyclock weir was impassable to Atlantic salmon and many other fish species. In 2013, this was partially removed.